I want to talk a little about old school RuneScape, legacy code, tech debt, and when I got started back with OSRS. Tech debt is a term used to describe future work that accumulates in coding and tech projects from choosing the easier, faster option rather than the better but longer approach. This may sound like a choice that seems obvious at first, but in actual applications, it makes perfect sense usually so long as you track and manage your tech debt. Let's look at this in regards to old school RuneScape. OSRS was restored from a backup, not some kind of perfect archive where everything was preserved and well cut off from other development. It came with all the in-flight development, current bugs, and anomalies of the game at the time. Except now it is years later, with developers having moved on, huge technological changes, and likely little to no surviving documentation on what works, why, and how. This is an example of taking on tech debt to get something out sooner, and was likely the correct choice. The ideal choice, no doubt, was to spend years recreating the game faithfully in every little detail with a better backend and development environment and to having dedicated developers to support it after release. Sure, this would have been amazing, but it isn't something I think most companies could realistically afford on what was, at the time, a giant gamble. While we established the creation of the old school RuneScape was a reasonable choice, we have to recognize that it brought with it just massive amounts of tech debt, something that needs to be dealt with sooner or later. Fast forward, OSRS has been released, it works, so now what? Can the devs take a ton of time off without updates to solve all of their problems? Not really, the game still needs consistent updates that it was known for to stay alive, and they are the highest priority. As a player, if I am still receiving these updates, why should I care about a thing such as tech debt? The ultimate cost of tech debt is that it just slows everything down, and like real debt, it must eventually be paid. Imagine an OSRS where all new minigames were just reskins like Nightmare Zone. Quests come out like once or twice a year, and new content quickly dies off because the cost of developing in such a legacy system is just too much for a dev team to handle. As a player, one should be aware of this not because it's their problem to solve or that it should affect their polling votes, but instead be aware that good code and good games really do take time. Time that sometimes is not best spent making more game, but instead taking a few hours each week to solve some cryptic issue or challenge that doesn't seem related to gameplay at first glance. I wanted to do a video on this because while I don't think it matters to the average old school player, it was something that I relate to heavily in my own life. I started playing old school in my final year of college as a computer engineering major. I love the nostalgic feeling of playing this game I loved as a kid and walking through all these old memories. After graduation, I was hired by a company with its own legacy system. The code I was working on was in a language called Cache, an obscure language originally called Mumps and used for hospital data systems. This code was old. I could easily find code that was created before I was born, made even scarier by the fact that the creation date was the only comment in that code. Tackling these monsters was never a priority, but you knew it had to be done eventually. It was tech debt, and it was only going to get worse the more you ignore it. Your only real hope was to slowly and very deliberately make tiny little changes to the code in such a way that you could hopefully make it possible to one day actually work on it. Listening to the OSRS Q&As made me relate so much because I was tackling similar problems and techniques. I could understand the joy of certain small changes coming in, because that might just get me close enough to a real issue I could finally try and work on. Or the frustration of some overwhelming monster like engine work that while we all know is needed, we just can't ever seem to fit into the schedule and resources a team has. I think we will never know some of the stuff the OSRS team does in the background that pays off dividends later. Small little passion projects and ideas that let them conquer this massive monster of old game code, accelerating them in creating more of the old school RuneScape we all know and love. Hey, I'm Grant. I make these little discussion videos on OSRS every Saturday in my spare time with my views as a more casual player. A like and a subscribe goes a long way to make sure these keep coming out, and if you ever want to, you can contact me in-game under the same name if you ever just want to chat or lend any advice. Hope to see you around the channel, and I'll be back again next Saturday.